Well, how much is it?
A little over $2 million. Per split.
Holy mother God.
Once everything settled up, I'm calling the man I know, having him bring over 3 hookers.
Boy, ain't no hooker ever stepping foot in this house.
You sure? 'Cause 2 of them are for you.
I'm gonna be fucking in my new drifter.
I'd appreciate that.
You know, my entire life, there's always been someone standing over me, telling me where I could go, what I could do, who I could be seen with. This. What you boys did tonight. This changes everything. This isn't just money. It's freedom. Real freedom. There ain't no one standing over me again. Over any of us. Huh? Vouloir, c'est pouvoir, eh?
Well, well, well.
Man,
look at
the man.
Ho! And look at what I dug up.
You mind pouring one more of those?
Holy shit.
It'll be my pleasure.
Georgie told me shit went sideways during the robbery. Lincoln had to save your ass. You should be damn proud of that, boy.
I am, Sal. More than you'll ever know.
Oh, Jesus Christ, that is some down-home hooch right there, isn't it?
All right.
Listen, I got a guy outside. Y'all mind if he comes in and packs up my cut?
Not at all.
Look at that.
Let's see if you can handle this down-home hooch.
Yeah, why don't you give me some of that?
Trying to get some corn whiskey? Make you a man.
They all the same.
Hey, take the one on the end. It's your cut, plus what I owe you. Even put in a little extra for your trouble.
Couldn't have pulled it off without you, Sammy. Y'all done right by me tonight. Mwah. Mwah. Why don't you get us some off the top shelf? We need to celebrate.
Oh, yeah. You ain't got to tell me, twice. Yeah.
Hey, fill me up. All
right. You know something, Lincoln? You're possibly the baddest motherfucker I ever laid my eyes on. You shouldn't have said no.
Where the fuck you think you're going? Stupid fucking niggas.
Go on, grab that bag. Let's go.
When I got to Sammy's, the whole place was burning. I still don't know what brought me there that night. Luck? Divine providence?
I just picked up this call between Mr. Frank Pagani and Tommy Marcano. The first voice you're gonna hear is Frank's.
The fuck you mean it's gone? He came in and killed everybody.
Christ, what a goddamn mess. I never seen Sal so pissed. You gotta get your ass back here, like, right fucking now.
Sal's pissed? What about me, huh? Down here busting my ass, and now I have to deal with this shit?
I told you.
I take care of you, and I stand by that. When you're back in town and things calm down, I'll make it right.
Yeah, well, you fucking better. Boat's taking off here in a few minutes. I gotta finish up with some things. Then I'll fly back when I can.
I checked with Vessel Traffic Services, and they're expecting the Tanager to arrive any time now. Frank's a slippery bastard, so I have no idea where he'll end up once he's back in the city. His car is on the Tanager, though. And from what I hear, he loves that goddamn thing.
So if I can get onto the boat and plant this, I'll be able to track wherever he goes.
It's the same model we used against the Soviets. Has a mercury-based trigger. Once you see the signal, just follow it.
After I put this onto his car, we'll take apart the rest of his district. No sense in leaving any loose ends.
I'm sure Frank will appreciate your thoroughness.
The investigation was a mess from the very start. The locals did everything they could to keep us out of it, but that wasn't the worst of it. Someone actually broke into our offices and not only stole all of our files, but they also took most of our surveillance equipment.
Ah!
I never did anything to you.
Saw some interesting stuff back there. Counterfeit money, a press. Only thing I can't figure out is a connection to Cuba.
Please. I'm all busted up inside. I need a doctor. I got a wife and three little girls.
Yeah, you want a doctor? Then you better tell me something worth hearing.
Listen, what you saw. Sal set all that up. None of the money was worth a shit, though. Had me bringing a man named Alvarez. Counterfeiter who works for Castro.
He give you the plates, too?
Plates? I thought you knew. On account of robbery.
Robbery? Marcano wanted the plates from the Federal Reserve. How do I find Alvarez? How?
One of Tommy's guys picked him up. It was 10, 15 minutes before you showed up.
Where are they taking him? Where? Huh?
My little girls.
No. Fuck!
I've spent the last 48 years pursuing Lincoln Clay because he's a criminal. It's horrible what happened to him, but you know something? I think that when Sammy Ellis and Danny Burke were killed, it revealed who Lincoln Clay really was. A monster.
Look, I gave you some names and I'm paying you to chase them down, so don't give me any of that bullshit. Yeah, okay, just get it done. Christ, sometimes I think if you want something done right. You all right?
The night Sammy was so happy. Happier than I ever seen him. That money was supposed to get him, get all of us out from under Marcano. Motherfucker!
What the hell did Frank tell you?
Marcano had us rob the reserve so he could get his hand on a set of money plates. Georgie must have grabbed him during the robbery. I should have been paying attention.
We already had this conversation. None of this is your fault.
Like hell it isn't.
Sal is a cancer. A leech. He had always intended to fuck all of you. Christ, look what he did to Vito. He murdered your family. The only way to make that right is by killing every cocksucker who's ever looked at that piece of shit.
Give me some of that bourbon. According to Pagani, Marcano couldn't print the money himself, so he had a Cuban counterfeiter named Alvarez brought in. What do we know about South Downs?
Tommy Marcano isn't the kind of guy who shits where he eats, so his rackets are pretty low-key. He runs a sports book and has a place where he stores his contraband.
Tommy's got to know that I'm coming after Alvarez, so he's probably got him holed up in or near one of those places. One way or another, I'll get my hands on him. I'll be damned if I let Marcano print a single fucking dollar from one of those plates.
Why'd I become a priest? Every bad thing you experience, every trauma, they never leave you. Sure, you might forget about them for a while, but when the next one comes along, no matter how slight, it brings everything back. It reminds you of the weight you've been lugging around. I knew I couldn't carry all that on my own.
Bishop Jenkins sent me to St. Michelle's Home for Colored Boys. That orphanage was a pile of shit from the day I got there till the day I left. But I loved it. I loved helping those boys.
This part of town's run by a man named Tony D'Orazio. From what I was able to piece together, he's a real fucking weirdo. Some kind of savant when it comes to numbers.
Then he must be the one who runs Lou Marcano's books.
Runs his books, launders his money. Hell, he even manages Lou's relationships with city officials. It's Tony's job to make sure their asses stay greased.
How do I get to him?
Well, that's where things get interesting. Tony lives in the penthouse on the top floor of the Royal Hotel. Elevator access is restricted, and the rest of the hotel's crawling with Tony's goons.
Well, he can't stay up there all the time. I'm gonna need a schedule for when he comes and goes.
I've been watching this cocksucker for a month now, and he's left exactly one time. That was because one of his men fucked up. Took a pipe to the poor bastard's left arm.
Well, looks like he's got a front business he uses to issue bribes and launder Lou's money. And another one that soaks up funds from the city. I hit him. He overreacts, then I get my opening.
And fuck up things between him and Lou in the process. Be careful with this one. Just because Tony's a goddamn spastic doesn't mean he won't cut your balls off if given the chance.
Really?
I have a subscription.
Tommy Marcano brought in a counterfeiter from Cuba, right?
Sal spent a couple of months trying to print the money himself, but none of it was worth a damn. The color was wrong, printing was cockeyed, you name it. He needed someone who knew what the fuck they were doing. So he used his connections and found a man named Alvarez.
And this Alvarez was also counterfeiting money for Castro.
Most of our enemies counterfeit American money. Hell, some of our allies do too.
Sorry, he's gone.
What do you mean, he's gone? All you had to do is drive down to the goddamn lighthouse and pick him up.
It's not my fault Alvarez is running all over the goddamn place. I wanted to lock his ass up, but you wouldn't hear of it. The last thing we need is Zaraga finding out that we treated his nephew like dog shit. You understand? Then Lincoln Clay comes in shooting the shit out of it.
Lincoln Clay. Lincoln Clay. I'm so sick and fucking tired of hearing about this cocksucker. He's just one man. A fucking nigga. We're skating a thin line here, Tommy. You understand? This thing falls apart. We fucked all of us.
So, what the fuck would you do?
What the fuck would I do?
Listen, science. If that fucking nigga got to Alvarez, it means he knows the place. He's after him. You understand? You understand? Get your ass down to the motherfucking gym and protect them.
Yeah, sure. I'm on it.
This shit ends right here, right now. No more fuck-ups.
Fuck me.
Operated.
Tommy knew Lincoln was coming for the plates. Tommy knew Lincoln was coming for the plates, but he felt he had to keep up appearances. The second he started canceling fights and shutting the place down was the second people started thinking he was out of his league. He wasn't about to allow that to happen.
How did Lincoln Clay gain access to the gym?
He had me track down a man named Alcee Bennett. Alcee's a small-time hustler that worked for Sammy until he double-crossed him and was kicked out of the Hollow. After that, he scratched out a living recruiting fighters for Tommy's jungle fights. If he vouched for Lincoln at the door, Lincoln could get in without a big ruckus.
Lucky.
You must think I'm some kind of goddamn moron coming in here like you did.
I've never been one to shy away from a calculated risk.
Maybe you should have. I'll mix some vegetable oil in. Mix the gasoline thick. Sticky. We're just gonna let it soak in a little bit. Work his way into every nook and cranny. That way when I light it, that shit's gonna burn like napalm.
What happened to the money plates that Sal Marcano stole from the Federal Reserve?
I don't recall.
Georgie, get your ass in here.
Thank you.
Your Uncle Tommy's dead. I thought you'd like to know.
Sorry, Pops. I know what he meant to you.
He was a smart kid, your Uncle Tommy. Could have been anything. I tried to tell him, go to college. Even offered to pay for it. Instead, he went to Cuba.
It's not your fault.
Yeah. Well, we're pretty well fucked now, you understand? And I was counting on that counterfeit money without it. Yeah.
Well, now there's got to be something we can do. You go put the squeeze on people. Get to increase what they're kicking up.
It ain't gonna be enough. Just because you poke holes in someone doesn't mean you're gonna get anything extra out of them.
Could always call Leo Galante. Ask him to front...
Fuck him! The whole reason I'm building this goddamn casino is to get out from under them worthless fucks. Not bringing the commission, they're gonna want to cut everything. God damn it. Go on, get the hell out of here. I gotta make a call. Get out! Shit. Leo! How the fuck are you? It's Sal. Yeah? Listen, I got something I need to discuss.
Tried to reconcile the help Lincoln with the part of me that vowed to follow the teachings of Jesus Christ. But I can't. You know what I remember? I remember watching the news and learning they had gunned down Dr. King. I remember watching people lash out, riot, because that's all they had left. All the while, Lincoln's in the other room, barely clinging to life. Maybe that's why I did what I did.
It took me months to figure out that Lincoln had survived the massacre at Sammy's and was waging a war against Sal Marcano. The Bureau didn't have a file on Clay, and I wasn't aware of his military training because his service records were classified. Otherwise, I might have started to connect the dots after the death of Richie Doucette.
Jesus Christ! I'm gonna shot you in the goddamn face.
Now we're even.
Fucking asshole.
Time to call Enzo.
Alright. Dial this. Yeah.
Who the fuck is this?
Take a guess.
Got a lot of nerve calling me like this. You know who the fuck I am?
I know exactly who you are, Enzo.
Your mob lieutenant was just lost control of his district. Marcano will probably end up playing you next to Michael Greco.
You goddamn coward. You want me dead? Be a man. Do it yourself.
I don't want you dead, Enzo. I want to make a deal.
A deal? Jesus Christ, son. You need to get your fucking head examined.
You tell me who's behind the construction of Marcano's casino, and I'll do what I can to keep that wop asshole from killing you.
Why the fuck should I think you could protect me from Marcano?
Look at what I did to you.
Meet me at the quarry.
Next time, don't let me catch you napping.
Kiss my ass. Yeah, that's what I...
John Donovan and Lincoln Clay embarked on a campaign of urban destruction this country hadn't seen since the Civil War. Remy Duvall came from one of the most respected and wealthiest families in Louisiana. He invested in everything from oil wells to real estate, and he used his social status to get a radio program. Now, he used his radio show to preach about the collapse of polite society and the superiority of the Southern way of life. His family had been here for a couple of centuries, so his death was a shock. But even more shocking was the revelation that he was associated with the Southern Union, a group of wealthy racists who used their social positions to agitate against blacks.
Remy Duvall, he was crucified and then burned alive. How do you justify that type of behavior?
Remy came from a long line of Southern cocksuckers, was always quick to trot out that war of Northern aggression and the South will rise again bullshit. Here's the thing about Remy. In 1965, he participated in the murder of four civil rights workers, one of whom they decapitated. They never found her head, so fuck him, he got what he deserved. Sounds like your assessment of Remy Duvall was spot on. Listen to this.
Look at what he's doing to us. Our neighborhood, our homes. I, for one, refuse to sit by and watch as some rubber-lipped nigger runs roughshod over everything we hold dear.
And what is it you hope to accomplish?
I will strangle that motherfucker, that's what I'll accomplish. I apologize. Shouldn't use that kind of language.
He is egging you on, Remy. You are much too important to be caught up in all of this. Is the situation unfortunate? Of course it is. But nothing he is doing changes anything. Let Sal's men handle it.
Sal's men? Olivia, the people of this neighborhood expect me to protect them, not some greased up WAP assholes. No. I need to respond to this. I need to send a message to those niggas and the guineas. But here in Frisco Fields, we take care of our own.
This is a mistake, Remy. You could jeopardize everything we have been working toward.
Our very way of life is at stake, and you think I give a goddamn about some casino? Sometimes I think you've forgotten your station in life, Olivia.
A minute or so later, Olivia called Sal, told him Remy's Southern Union pals were out looking for you. If you head back up there, I'm sure it won't be long before you run into some of them. Get them to tell you which hole Remy's hiding in.
Yeah, once I'm done with that prick, Olivia's next. Getting to someone like her ain't gonna be easy. Between Marcano's men and all those rich white assholes she runs around with, they'll spot me coming a mile away. I need you to look at our options. Come up with a plan.
Okay. I'm gonna look at our options and come up with a plan.
What's wrong with you, man?
Personal hygiene is very important.
What now, nigga? What now? Have it your way.
A horrific scene here in Frisco Fields as one of the city's most prominent citizens, Remy Duvall, was savagely murdered. Witnesses report he was bound to a cross and set on fire. Let's see if we can get a statement from the police. Chief Wilson, you care to make a comment?
It's those goddamn niggas. Every last one of them needs to be rounded up and shot.
That's quite a statement, Chief.
You need to wipe the shit out of your eyes, son. Take a look around. There's a goddamn war going on.
I still don't understand. why Olivia Marcano was involved in any of this. By all accounts, she had two or three times the money that Sal Marcano had.
Money didn't mean shit to her. From what I was able to piece together, she hired someone to kill Lucho. Wanted to run things herself. Bottom line, I think she got off on all that mob bullshit.
We're fucked, Olivia. You understand? That fucking shit-stained Duval didn't name us in the will. Now everything's going to his goddamn nephew?
Have you actually reviewed the will?
I read the part that said all the land I'm building my casino on is now going to Stephen motherfucking DeGamo. I read that part.
6 months ago, Remy revised the will, but he never executed it.
What the hell are you talking about?
In order for the will to be valid, it needs to be signed.
Well, goddammit, woman, I know that. What does it mean for us?
It means I have grounds to contest. Remy and I were business partners in several ventures, and one of my holding companies lists the land as an ancillary asset.
Sounds like a lawyer's wet dream. What's something like that gonna run me?
I haven't the slightest idea.
Nearly every cent I got is tied up in that goddamn casino. I can't afford a big legal fight. There's got to be another way out of this mess.
Stephen is coming to town for the funeral. I could arrange a meeting. Offer him a percentage of the casino's profits if he signs over the land.
Yeah. Yeah, that could work. And then once he signs, we take care of him. All right, set it up. But my patience is at its goddamn end. Do you understand, Olivia? I'm tired of this bullshit.
Have a little faith, Sal.
Now, Mr. Clay entered the country club disguised as a waiter.
Everyone in attendance was a rich asshole or part of the Southern Union, so getting Lincoln in there was easy. You put a black man in a uniform and he's damn near invisible. Hell, I drove in through the front gate and dropped him off. No one even gave us a second look.
No. Surely, his uniform wasn't enough to get him past Mrs. McConnell's personal security detail.
I mixed up a vial of fast-acting LSD. You know, same basic formula that we use as part of MKUltra. And I gave it to Lincoln. He used a syringe and put a couple of drops into every drink he served. Within a couple of minutes, anyone who drank that concoction was whacked out of their goddamn mind.
I never thought.
You get shot.
Precisely. The first time I saw Lucho, he looked so handsome. Dashing, even. He wore the finest suits. Drove the best cars. There was always something terribly romantic about all of this.
Ain't nothing romantic about robbing and killing people.
Maybe not. But it certainly was exciting.
Where's DeGamo?
DeGamo. They have me out in a building. Down by the wall. Thought you were gonna kill me.
You ain't worth the trouble.
What happened to Stephen DeGamo?
Lincoln left him with me, and I got him the hell out of there.
And you still know DeGamo's whereabouts?
Like I'd tell any of you assholes.
It's Marcano. I'm here with your breakfast. Let's freshen this room up. Get some of that sunlight in here. That's better.
Are you telling me Lincoln Clay did not murder Olivia Marcano?
He didn't kill women unless he had no other choice.
I find that very hard to believe.
Back in 67, we were in a bar in Saigon,
and this gook bitch comes strolling in. Skirt barely covering her ass, and she starts offering everybody blowjobs.
G.I. wants sucky fucky. G.I. wants boom boom.
Then she pulls out a grenade and she kills three guys. A couple Marines at the bar want to cut that bitch's head off, but Lincoln stops them. Keeps him off her until the MPs show up. If he wasn't going to kill that slag, he sure as fuck wasn't going to kill Olivia Marcano.
Who'd you send?
I did it myself, ear to ear, just like you wanted.
Good boy. Leave us alone. I got business to discuss. I understand you supplied the heroin Georgia was selling.
Si, certo.
I never wanted that in my city. Shit like that fucks with people's heads. It makes them crazy. Stupid. It brings down too much heat. Bourbon?
No, I do not drink.
Georgie, tell you why I wanted to meet.
He said the nigger is causing you problem, that you wish to discuss a deal between the two of us.
I'm building a casino across the lake. I had it all set. Now the rights to the land are all tied up. It's a goddamn mess.
You want my money.
I'm gonna need enough to pay for all the blood-sucking lawyers, and that's not cheap.
I want to hear you say it.
Say what?
That you want my money. Say those words, please.
I want your money.
This is good. I will bring you the money, and in exchange, you will let me sell heroin in your city, and you will not interfere in any way.
Sure, whatever you want. But that's not the only thing that
you also wish for me to kill the nigger. I will do that for you as well. I enjoy killing the niggers.
Jesus Christ.
That's where Sammy's used to be. No one wanted to live there, so they paved it over. Now and then, something knocks the hell out of this country. Rattles it so hard, isn't much left but the foundation. And as painful as it is, we hope that this time, things are gonna be different. And that when it's time to rebuild, we won't just repeat what we've done in the past. And that maybe justice and peace will finally prevail. Justice and peace are hard, ain't it? Sometimes too hard. So we take the easy way.
I'm of two minds when it comes to Lincoln's legacy. On the one hand, he was a brutal criminal who killed God knows how many people, a new breed of mobster, a prototype for criminals to come. Someone like that doesn't deserve the position history has afforded him. He should be forgotten, erased. But I also understand that Lincoln had a significant impact on the Italian mob in this city. He did what the Bureau wouldn't or couldn't do. He finished them.
How did you manage to get to Tony D'Orazio?
I had bugs and wiretaps all over the damn place. When that weirdo left the Royal Hotel to deal with one of his men, I was listening.
Tony, I didn't know you was coming. I'm just packing away your latest shipment.
How long you been running this business, Joe?
I know, 5, 6 years.
5 years, 3 months, and 18 days. Well, this has turned.
Look, I know I've been lying, but it ain't my fault.
I've always placed a premium on maintaining order. If you let the rot set in, eventually it will take hold and destroy everything you've built. The only solution is to isolate it, eradicate it before it takes hold. You understand, Joe?
Christ, Donnie, you gotta listen to me. Some nuts out there shooting the hell out of everything. You know how many of my men he killed?
Yes. Dominic, is it? You will take the armored car and personally oversee the collection of all outstanding monies owed to us. Am I clear on this?
Yes, Mr. Razio.
Once you have collected what is due, deliver it directly to me at the hotel. The code to the elevator is 0451.
From there, Lincoln had a couple of options. He could use the elevator code and go in through the lobby, which meant shooting the hell out of the place. Or he could steal Dominic's car and go in quiet through the hotel's parking garage.
So I gotta hear stories about some bitch running all over the goddamn place, smashing our shit to pieces? I wanna know what the fuck's going on down there. You hear me?
It would be difficult not to.
What?
I've already taken the appropriate steps to address the situation. Believe me, things are well in hand.
Well, they fucking better be. If this thing with the judge goes sideways, shit's gonna roll downhill real fucking quick.
We haven't lost anything of any significance except for some men. And they can be replaced. In fact, they're the easiest thing to replace.
Son doesn't give two shits about any of those stupid fucks. All he cares about is the people that matter. Understand?
I understand completely. And you have my word that all payments will continue as scheduled. None of our business associates need to concern themselves with our recent difficulties.
Yeah? Okay. I'm counting on you here, Tony. Don't fuck this up.
Goodbye.
You really think you know how all this is gonna play out, don't you? Idiot! Go ahead. Kill me. I'll be replaced tomorrow. No one will even notice.
You're wrong. Everyone will notice.
War on the streets of our fair city as a gunman stormed the Royal Hotel, killing an untold number of men.
There was a loud crash, like a bomb going off. I looked up and there was a man falling from the top of the building.
And all these men showed up and every one of them had a gun. They ran into the Royal and that's when the shooting started.
I still don't know how the hell Lincoln got out of that hotel.
Police are intensifying their search for the colored male believed to be responsible for the massacre at the Royal Hotel. The suspect is described as 6'3" and is believed
They're
to be
saying you threw Tony off the roof of the Royal?
Actually, it was through his penthouse window.
You always had a flair for the dramatic.
Tony's ledger. Last couple pages are pretty interesting.
Any idea what US5CJ means? Wait a minute. Holy shit. Why is Lou willing to comb 10 grand a month at a brothel and the same at a drug den?
Based on what Greco told me in Scaletta, Marcano's laying out a bunch of money to get gambling legalized. And if that's what you're after, who better to have in your pocket?
Than a judge on the Fifth Circuit Court of Appeals, US5CJ.
Exactly.
There have to be over 20 judges on that bench. Could be any one of them.
The kind of man we're talking about isn't used to people getting into his business. I start visiting the places listed in that ledger. He'll panic. and go to Lou for help.
And that's when we'll find out who he is.
Keep that wiretap running.
Never turn it off.
And after Lincoln Clay killed the last, capo, that's when he turned his sights on Sal Marcano.
Listen, it's like I said before. It's the same op who ran over in Vietnam. You want to bring down the dipshit in charge? You target their men and infrastructure. Eliminate their ability to fight back. And before they know it, they're standing there all alone, ass hanging out in the wind.
I got a name for your judge. Cornelius Holden. He just made a call to Lou.
Not get worked up. I'll bail you more than that, Lunatic Lou. Then I'll pay me enough. I'll stop you right there, Cornelius. Never know who might be listening in. You need to get this shit under control yet. Because until you do, your brother's case isn't going anywhere. There's no call for that kind of talk. I'll send over a call, a couple of my best men. They'll see to it that you're kept safe.
Cornelius is 60. The dipshits of this state first elected him to the Fifth Circuit in 1951. There's something else you should know. Those two men are Lamont Harris and Trey McCall. They were killed by a man named Hollis Dupree.
Yeah, I heard he gunned them down when they showed up to his house asking for help.
Hollis claims it was in self-defense, said he thought they were there to kill him. Cornelius is the judge that's presiding over the trial.
So killing him might kick up a lot of noise.
Cornelius is an entitled southern asshole. Killing him is going to do a lot more than kick up some noise. Hopefully, it'll send a message that it's long past the time that those cocksuckers went extinct. That's the car down there that Lou was talking about.
That thing armored?
I pulled the work order for it. It's a complete custom job. Tough as hell. It'll take a pounding, but it won't be impossible. Cornelius is scheduled to leave any time now, so this is your window.
Do you follow a set route?
Not since the trial started, but he still makes a stop or two on the way home. So, you can either hit him then, or go after him when he's driving around.
All right.
Lou Marcano was bribing a district judge named Cornelius Holden, is that correct?
Sal Marcano spent a lot of money getting Holden in his pocket. A lot of money. Judges like that don't come cheap. And with Holden out of the picture, Sal had to find someone else to legalize gambling.
And that person was State Senator Walter Jacobs.
That's right.
You had one fucking job, Lou. Now it's to keep holding him one goddamn pistol after that room.
What was I supposed to do? He wouldn't listen, Sal. It ain't my fault.
Nothing's ever your goddamn fault. I swear, if you wasn't my brother, I'd clip you myself.
Now listen here. I know a guy. A state senator named Jacobs. He's on the Revenue and Fiscal Affairs Committee. Has a lot of influence.
Can we get to him?
Already have. He has a thing for fucking on women who ain't his wife.
I don't want to twist this guy's balls out of the gate, you understand? We need to be smart about this.
Yeah, of course. How about I throw him a fundraiser on the riverboat? Show him a real nice time. Get him laid. All that shit.
This goddamn casino got me tapped, you understand? This goes down the shitter. We're fucked. All of us.
I'll pick the guests myself. Make sure they know what's what. Then we'll take a nice long cruise down the bayou, get them all liquored up. Once he sees that payday, Jacobs is gonna do whatever we want.
Lou Marcano knew everyone. I mean, politicians, merchants, lawyers, bankers. He insisted on being called Uncle Lou and was basically the Santa Claus of the French ward.
According to the police reports, Mr. Marcano and Mr. Jacobs were killed during a fundraiser on a riverboat.
Thing about the bayou is it's a very big place. You could blow the living shit out of everything in sight and no one would even notice.
What the fuck?
then, ain't none for you to worry about. Let's get you upstairs. You all fan out. Watch the rest of the boat. This sure shit wasn't an accident.
That's far enough, you wop asshole!
What the fuck, Lou?
Take another step and he gets it.
You think I give a shit about some politician?
Please! Please, I don't even know what's going on!
I don't want your money. I want you to send a message to your brother.
Yeah? Anything. Oh, just say it. Just say it.
Lord Almighty.
Jacobs was killed this evening in a fiery explosion aboard a riverboat. Local businessman Louis Marcano also lost his life, along with dozens of other wealthy donors there to attend a political fundraiser.
When Lincoln left his gutted body on a statue commemorating Andrew Jackson, people were horrified. I mean, how could that be anything but a political statement?
Lincoln once told me he couldn't turn the other cheek, that the world doesn't work that way. I spent the better part of 40 years trying to prove him wrong. I was just lying to myself. Look at how we treat each other. Compassion is a sign of weakness, but greed is a virtue. The poor is considered morally corrupt while every excess of the powerful is celebrated. We sent kids off to die. For what? So someone can make a few bucks? Lincoln was right. He was always right. There ain't never gonna be another Dr. King or a Bobby Kennedy. But there always gonna be another Sal Marcano, another Sammy Robinson, another Lincoln Clay. We are cruel and wicked people.
Wasting any time, are you?
Your little rampage is going to attract attention. Attention from people I don't care to associate with.
Yeah, imagine not.
Thankfully, closing off your loose ends is as simple as tossing around some super grade. With any luck, this will keep them off my ass. For a little while, anyway. But we're getting ahead of ourselves. There's still the matter of killing Georgie and Sal. You should get a kick out of hearing this.
Goddamn motherfucking piece of shit!
Luke's dead.
They found him tied to that statue of Jackson over in the French ward. He was gutted like a goddamn catfish.
Jesus fucking Christ.
This was that goddamn nigga Lincoln Clay. We would not be in this fucking mess if you'd done what you were supposed to do.
You were there? I shot him right in the fucking head.
Once! You shot him once! I am leveraged out their ass!
called in every favor, and none of it made a goddamn difference. We're fucked. I am fucked.
Oh, now that's bullshit. We still got some men. I say we hit the streets and we find that cocksucker.
Every low-life ball of piss in this city smells blood in the water. My blood. Do you understand? And they'd step over their own mother if it meant being the one that clipped me. I wouldn't last 10 fucking minutes out there.
That's a crock of shit. You forget? You are Sal Marcano. Well, there's got to be something we can do.
Call whatever men we still have left.
You telling me to stop there at the casino?
And when Lincoln Clay shows up, we're gonna do everything we can to plant that goddamn nigga in the ground. Right next to us. That's what we can do. Go on, get the fuck out of here. Go!
Should have known that Marcano would go to ground at the casino.
You can take the bridge up there, so it's a straight shot.
You know, none of this would have happened without you.
It's either this or right away in some goddamn office. And once you've killed those assholes, you come and find me. I'll be hanging around over at the Padres.
You got it.
You give them hell, champ. You stupid motherfucker.
I always thought you were my friend. That you had me and Ellis's backs. It was just an act. You didn't kill me because I said no. You killed me because you thought you owned me. Owned all of us.
It was never about us. It was about my old man. My father. I did anything for him. Same as you and Sammy.
Then you understand why I have to do this.
Much of a chance of that happening now, is it?
Doesn't look that way.
Take a seat. I ain't going nowhere. Hey, not bad.
I think I still prefer Shine.
You know, a month or so after my brother Lucho died, I started having nightmares. I had this one where I was on a boat. Giant wave come, knocked my ass overboard. I hit that water and sink like a goddamn rock. Then there was another one where cottonmouths biting me all to hell. But the one that really got to me was George's funeral. He's laid out in that shitty little casket. Neck cut, same as Lucho's. Yeah, that one really got to me. It'll come around again every 3 or 4 days.
That one where I'm back in Nam, sleeping in a foxhole. All of a sudden, these dark figures come out of the shadows. I try to fight them off, but they hold me down, tie my hands together, stuff a muddy rag in my mouth so I can't scream, can't warn the man sleeping next to me. And then I gotta listen as all those men die.
I would imagine that's not gonna go away anytime soon.
No. I imagine it won't.
than this. This was all to try to keep mine from coming true. Look how that turned out. I buried a lot of people. More than I can count. The one I never wanted to see go down in that cold ground was my son.
And yet here we are.
Yes, sir. Here we are. My son is dead. And I'm having a drink with his killer. I'm not gonna apologize for what I did, you understand? If I did, I'd just be lying. I don't have it in me to feel shame for the things I've done to others. Never have.
Didn't come here for an apology.
Nah. I know you didn't. Goddamn, I was right about you, wasn't I? I knew it the second I fucking saw you at the country club. Men like us, we're just wired up wrong. There's only one thing we know. One thing we're good at. I won't be waiting for you, Lincoln Clay. This won't be the last time we see each other.
I know.
I take it you're Lincoln Clay.
So they tell me.
I told Sal this fucking casino would be the end of him. I meant it figuratively. This shit has a way of turning on you, doesn't it?
Especially if you piss off the wrong person.
You know who I am, son?
Guessing you're Leo Galante.
Take a little walk, you and me. Probably no surprise, but the rest of the commission wants you dead. You and anybody else that had anything to do with this.
What happened here was between me and Marcano.
Oh, I understand that, son. We all do. But this business makes you paranoid, irrational. They see Sally up pile of shit. They start wondering if someone's gonna serve them a plate of their own.
So you're here to decide if you're coming after me?
No. I'm here to deliver a message. You made your point, son. This all ends right here. Right now.
I got no quarrel with y'all.
Once a month, Sal kicked up 20% of his net. Cash only. Same man's been delivering it for, oh, I don't know, 40 years or so. I see no need in deviating from that, you?
No, sir.
In exchange, you run things as you see fit. Wanna sell heroin? Want a whorehouse on every other corner? Makes no fucking difference to me. The only thing that matters is 20%.
And what if I decide to walk away? Leave all this behind?
Then this will be the last time we see each other. Best of luck to you, son.
Is he dead?
Yeah, he's dead. Him and Georgie both.
It's the best news I've heard in ages. Can we get an amen, Padre?
So what happens now?
What do you mean, what happens now? It's over. Done. Finished.
I ain't talking to you. Just cause Sal McConnell's dead, Lincoln, doesn't mean it's over. Now, what you did and the size of it all, you created a storm in this here city, and it's gonna take a long time for it to dissipate, if it ever does.
With McConnell dead, New Bordeaux belongs to me. Ain't nobody left to stand in my way.
You can't be serious. The point of this wasn't to replace Marcano. It was to remove him. This city's done gone through enough. It doesn't need another South Marcano.
This city? You've got to be fucking kidding me. This city is a cesspool. It's where people come to fuck and drink and get high.
You watch your filthy mouth.
It's what the city is, Padre. If it's not given another Sal Marcano, it's gonna shit one out.
He's right. If it ain't gonna be me, it's gonna be somebody else. Probably somebody worse.
Amen.
Hank. You remember what you told me when you came back from the war? How you wanted to go to California, leave all this behind, and just start all over?
Yeah.
Well, it ain't too late, Lincoln. You can still go. Go! And don't look back.
Listen, I'd love to stay here and debate the merits of one crime boss over another, but I've got a schedule to keep. Bit of advice, though. The scumbags you've been working with, kill them. All of them. Bury them before they bury you, buddy. Oh. I'll be seeing you, Padre.
God forgive me for standing by you through all this, Lincoln. But if you do anything except leave, we're finished. You hear? A man's soul can only carry so much. And mine is on the verge of breaking.
After Lincoln vanished, Vito Scaletta took over the city. I spit on Sal Marcano's grave one last time by actually doing what Marcano couldn't, finishing the casino. Now, 2 years later, Scaletta opened another casino, and then it was just an avalanche of development. Hotels, arenas, the new convention center. I mean, today everyone knows this place as the Las Vegas of the South, but the whole damn thing was built on bodies Lincoln Clay left behind with blood money he and his lieutenants stole from the mob. And Vito? He still lives in that penthouse at the top of Marcano's casino, looking out over the city he owns. After Sal Marcano's death, Lincoln Clay disappeared. The Bureau deprioritized the investigation after a few months, but I keep an active file. In 1971, I tracked him to a California shipyard where he was working under an assumed name. By the time we got there, though, he was gone. The trail went cold, and by 77, 78, I figured he was dead. But then I got a report of someone matching his description working with the Colombians. Since then, there's a new sighting of him every couple of years.
Lincoln made it out to California. Worked at the shipyards for a few years. Met him a woman. Seemed like he was gonna get married, but Then it all came apart. Don't know why. And he started moving around. He went to Alaska, New York, South America. He even went back to Vietnam. I still get postcards from time to time. You know, I think Lincoln wasn't able to accept the world for what it is, or his place in it.
Sal and Georgie are gone. And after all the shit we've been through, we run this city.
After all the bullshit, it's almost impossible for me to wrap my brain around the fact that we actually did it. You're a fucking saint, Lincoln. And I'm honored to know you.
So we finally gonna get our chance to make things right in this town. Bring a balance to things. Wasn't certain we'd ever actually get here.
It ain't personal.
You want to know what happened to Lincoln? After he killed those people he worked with, I realized that he was no different from Sal Marcano. So I put a bomb under his car. The things he did, that what he turned into. I did some things in my life. Things that I regret. But killing Lincoln Clay isn't one of them. He carved his path out all on his own.
After everything he did, all the people he killed? No, no. The car bomb was too quick, too clean. You know, sometimes I wonder when that priest, Father James Ballard, he identified the body. You know, some nights when I'm down here, going over it all again, I swear I hear footsteps upstairs. It sounds like combat boots. I know it's just this old house creaking and moaning. Well, when it happens, I can't help but wonder if it's Lincoln Clay coming to take what's left of my life.
Let me ask you something. Senator! Where were you when John Fitzgerald Kennedy was assassinated?
I don't remember. At home, I believe.
I don't remember. At home, I believe.
Let me tell you where I was. A muddy hut in Vietnam. Slowly dismembering an old woman. Cutting her apart bit by bit. And do you know why? Because her son was an NVA officer. And hurting her was the only way to make him talk.
I don't understand what this has to do
with... What he told us saved the lives of an entire platoon. That's 42 men. Men that lived another day because I was willing to take a saw to that old woman.
Thank you, Mr. Donovan. I believe that...
Sit down and just shut the fuck up! I did a lot of terrible shit over there. In the name of this country. Shit that will haunt me for the rest of my life. But I did it because I believed in the fight. I believed what this nation stood for. So, to be sitting there ass deep in mud with that old woman scattered all around me, and hearing that the President of the United States had just been fucking murdered? Well, I knew right then and there that I couldn't let that stand. That I would find a way to make it right, no matter how long it took.
What are you saying?
I'm saying that Sal Marcano and a group of conspirators murdered Jack Kennedy.
Oh, that is the most absurd thing I have ever heard.
I assume you would say that.
Don't fucking move!
This... You're out of your mind. Oh, I don't hold anyone's ambitions against them, Senator. And you certainly were ambitious, weren't you? You went to law school, and then you became a district attorney, and then the United States Senate. After Sal Marcano died, I went through his files. Imagine my surprise when I saw your name over and over and over and over again! The mob wanted Jack Kennedy dead, and you were more than willing to help. There are cameras everywhere. There's witnesses.
No, I want
you'll
them
never
to
get
see
away with this, you stupid asshole. Because then they will know that I am not finishing with you. I am starting with you. Stop! Oh. And they're next. Gentlemen,
God, partners.